We know that functions have Laurent expansions in annuli where they are analytic, but how can we find them? We have this general formula for their coefficients in terms of an integral, but that formula is usually impractical. We often use Taylor series we know, like the series of e to the power z or the geometric series, while we often cannot apply those known series directly. Usually one needs to rewrite a bit. In this video we will see a few examples of this procedure. We'll use the same function f of z all the time, but we will be using different centers, which means that we will find a number of different Laurent series for the same function. So we take our function f of z is 1 over z squared times z minus I. I want to find Laurent expansions for the first equation is then around which center point, and if you have some center point, in which region. So let's take as our center point in our first example z equals 0. So we expand around z equals 0. Now the 1 over z squared is fine already because it's already in a power series of the form z to the power n. So we are only left with the 1 over z minus I. So if we start expanding around z equals 0, we can expand until we come at the first singularity, which is at z equals I. So we can make an expansion in this angle over here between 0 and I, so with a radius of 1. And then we can make the next annulus. We can go beyond this 1, so we can make an expansion in the second angle is A2. So in this case we can make two Laurent expansions. The first one is annulus 1, where the norm of z is between 0 and 1, and the second is where the norm of z is bigger than 1. So how are we going to do that? So in A1 we know that the norm of z is smaller than 1, so we have to expand our 1 over z minus I, and we can expand it in powers of z because the norm of z is small. So we rewrite our 1 over z minus I in terms of a geometric series, so we need a 1 over here. So we have to take out a minus I, then I get a 1, and what we are left with is the minus z over I. And then we use a geometric series, 1 over 1 minus x equals some n from 0 to infinity x to the power n. We can apply this to our example. The minus the 1 over minus I becomes a factor of I, and our ratio equals z over I, so we get the geometric series of z over I to the power n. This converges if the ratio is smaller than 1, the norm of that, and in this case it means that the norm of z over I has to be smaller than 1. The norm of z over I equals the norm of z over the norm of I, norm of I equals 1, so this converges if the norm of z equals smaller than 1, which is exactly the case in our annulus 1. So then we can write our f of z, our 1 over z squared, which is already fine, times 1 over z minus I, which we just did. We leave the 1 over z squared, and we plug in the 1 over z minus I, which we found over there, which holds if norm of z is smaller than 1. And then, well, you can, for example, take in the 1 over z squared, so you get something which contains only powers of z. And there we go. There we have our f of z in annulus 1. On to annulus number 2. Again, the 1 over z squared is fine, because it's already written in terms of powers of z. We still have to do something with the 1 over z minus I. But now, in annulus 2, the norm of z is bigger than 1, so that means that the norm of 1 over z will be smaller than 1. So now we're looking into expanding this function in terms of 1 over z. So we have to rewrite our 1 over z minus I in terms of a geometric series with a ratio which has something to do with 1 over z. So we take out the 1 over z, that leaves us with a 1, so that's already fine, minus I over z over there. And now we can expand this using our geometric series again, in powers of I over z, because the norm of I over z equals the norm of I over the norm of z equals the norm of 1 over z is convergent if that is smaller than 1. So if the norm of z itself is bigger than 1, so it converges if norm of I over z is smaller than 1. So that means if norm of z is bigger than 1, which is exactly the case in this angulus 2. So we form our geometric series over here. And then we combine, we rewrite, because f of z was 1 over z squared times this 1 over z minus I. And take all powers of z in. And then there we have our second Laurent expansion. So now we know that Laurent expansions around z equals 0 in both angles, in the smaller one and the bigger one. Well, I can of course choose another center point as well. So how do you do that? Well, another obvious center point to choose is z equals I. So that will be your second example. What happens if we choose z equals I? Again, we have two annuli, A1 and A2, because we can start around z equals I and then continue our expansion until we arrive at the first singularity, which is now at z equals 0. So we have our first annulus over here, which holds if norm of z minus I is between 0 and 1. And then we have our annulus to our second annulus over here on the outside, which holds if the norm of z minus I is bigger than 1. So how are we going to do that? Well, now that we have our function f of z equals 1 over z squared times 1 over z minus I, now the term 1 over z minus I is fine, because we are looking into expanding in powers of z minus I. So the 1 over z minus I is already in the correct form. So now we only want to expand the 1 over z squared. But that is kind of awkward, because we want to rewrite in terms of a geometric series, and you don't want to do like 1 over z times 1 over z. You don't want to do a product of power series if you can prevent that. That's really awkward. Fortunately, we have a small trick, because our g of z equals 1 over z squared, that is the derivative of 1 over z, well, up to a sine. So what are we going to do? We are going to find the power series of 1 over z, and then we take the derivative to get our 1 over z squared. And the 1 over z is much easier than the 1 over z squared, as we will see. Because, well, 1 over z equals 1 over I plus z minus I. Of course, we add the I and subtract the I, because we want to expand in powers of z minus I. So we don't want z, we want to find factors z minus I. So that's what we have over here. Now, first, in the region where z minus I is small, so we want to have something like 1 minus z minus I over something. So we take out this factor of I to get the 1. And then I have to divide the z minus I by I as well. And I want 1 minus something, so we add an additional minus sign over there. And then make everything a bit nicer. The 1 over I equals minus I. And the minus 1 over I yields I. So we have this expression over here. And now our 1 over z is in the desired form, because now we can use our geometric series, but now around z minus I. So the minus I times 1 over 1 minus I over z minus I becomes a geometric series. You keep the minus I over there, and you expand the I times z minus I, the geometric series, which holds if the ratio is again smaller than 1, and the ratio is the norm of I times z minus I. So that equals the norm of z minus I, which has to be smaller than 1, which is exactly the case in this first annulus. And then we have our, then we can compute our g of z, because we have to differentiate and add a minus sign. So this minus sign cancels the other one out. And differentiating here the rubbish to the power n yields n times the rubbish to the power n minus 1, as you see. And you keep the I to the power n. So there we have our g of z. And then you get f of z just by multiplying with the 1 over z minus I. If you have the 1 over z squared, you are happy, because the 1 over z minus I is already in the appropriate form. So you multiply your g of z by 1 over z minus I. And there you go. There you have your Laurent expansion in the first annulus around I. Now we do the same sort of trick to find our Laurent expansion over here. And the second angle is, again, the 1 over z minus I is already fine. It's already in the correct form. So we have to deal again with the 1 over z squared. We do the same trick. We do the 1 over z first and then we differentiate. But now we have to be careful because we are expanding for z minus I in norm bigger than 1. So our 1 over z minus I will be something small. So what are we going to do? So we start with the same trick, 1 over z, I plus z minus I. But now we want to expand in 1 over z minus I. So we take out the z minus I and we get here something with the 1 over z minus I. Now we use again the geometric series. This constant factor remains in front. And we have us as a ratio now minus I over z minus I. So this geometric series over here converges if the norm of minus I over z minus I is smaller than 1, or if the norm of z minus I is bigger than 1, which is exactly the case in our annulus 2. So there we have our geometric series, and then we combine and find our g of z first by adding a minus sign over here and differentiating. So there we have our g of z, and then f of z, that's easy because it's just 1 over z minus I times g of z. But finally, here we have our Laurent expansion in the second annulus around I. Well, we can go on like this in the third example. We can also choose a third center point. For example, let's take z0 equals minus I. And now we have three annuli in which we can expand because we have a singularity now at 0 and at I. So if we start at minus I, we first encounter a singularity at 0. So that's our first annulus over here, A1, where z plus I in norm is smaller than 1. Then we can continue in the second annulus over here until we hit our next singularity. So our second annulus will be where the norm of z plus I is between 1 and 2, our A2. And then we can go on in our third annulus. So for this third example, I thought, well, let's do just one annulus. We sort of get now how to do this in the other annuli. So let's try to find the Laurent expansion in the annulus where 1 plus I converges. First of all, we have to separate fraction now. We're not so lucky that we can keep our 1 over z squared or our 1 over z minus I, because we are now looking for an expansion in terms of z plus I, so we will have to expand them both. We cannot do products. You don't want to do products if you can avoid it. Well, fortunately we can. We can separate the fraction. So we know our 1 over z squared over z minus I equals A over z squared plus B over z plus C over z minus I. So first we separate the fraction and then we can do the three terms separately. The three terms will just be, again, some geometric series. So how to separate the fraction, make them all under one fraction as we do over here, and then compare the powers. We have the powers of z squared. We have a bz squared here plus a cz squared, so b plus c equals no z squared over here, so equals 0. Powers of z, here we have a times z, and here we have a minus I b times z, so a minus I b also 0, because there are no powers of z on the left hand side. And with 1 we only have a minus I a, so minus I a equals 1, because we have a 1 on the left hand side. So the separation is quite easy here because you can start solving. Minus I times A equals 1, so A equals I. And then if you have A, you can use the equation over here. I minus I, B equals 0, so B has to be equal to 1. And B plus C equals 0, so C has to be equal to minus 1. So here we have our F of Z separated into three terms. And then we can do all terms separately. They all will be a geometric series. So we pick A2. We have our g of z equals 1 over z, our g1. So we first do our 1 over z, because if we have our 1 over z, we simply differentiate. And we have our minus 1 over z squared, So first the 1 over z, because that will give us the a over z squared term automatically as well. So we expand as z plus I minus I, because we want to have powers of z plus I. And then we see we want to be in angulus 2. So z plus I, the norm is between 1 and 2, so norm of z plus I is bigger than 1. So we form the, we take out the z plus I here, and we expand the factors of I over z plus I. And then we can again happily form a geometric series, our 1 over z plus I in front, and expand in I over z plus I, which converges if the norm of I over z plus I is smaller than 1, or if the norm of z plus I is bigger than 1, which is the case in our angulus 2. And there we have our series of 1 over z. Then we just differentiate to find g2 over there, because the ddz of 1 over z equals minus 1 over z squared. So we have our a and b terms, and we're just left with the c term. Well, z minus 1 equals z plus I minus 2i, and we have z minus I. We are again looking for a series in terms of z plus I. And then we can take out the 2i to get the 1 over here. So we have minus 2i times 1 minus z plus I over 2i. Now, in angulus 2 over here, the norm of z plus I is smaller than 2, so we can expand in z plus I over 2i. That's what we are going to do. We keep the I over 2 from over there, and then we use the geometric series again, which converges if the ratio norm is smaller than 1, the ratio is z plus I over 2i, or the norm of that is norm of z plus 2i over 2, which converges if that's smaller than 1, or if the norm of z plus I is smaller than 2, which is exactly the case in angulus 2. So then we combine all terms. We have our g1 of z over here. And we have our g2 of z, and we had our final term g3 of z. And we add them all up with the appropriate constants, which we found over here. And then we found our, finally, our f of z. So now you can do any Laurent series of this type around any point in any annulus. You see you're usually using the same type of tricks, but always remember, in which region are you? So how do you use the geometric series?